Yeah. Okay, cool. Looks like it's all working. And there's a bunch of people here. Well, hello, everybody. Thank you. So, I'm going to play some Quake maps. And hopefully it's an enjoyable experience. On my YouTube channel, I would regularly do this. So, I have on my whiteboard here a list of maps that I'm going to play. Let me know if everybody hears me okay and stuff. So, it's been a really awesome month for Quake releases. And I'll be playing the hottest stuff from the Quake crew. And I'm going to start with Biome by Pritchard. This is a map he's been working on for quite a while. And it's for AD 1.8. At the end of all this, I'll explain for anybody who might be new where you can find these hot, hot maps. And I'll link to like a quick start video if you're not up to speed on the Quake scene. But without further ado, let's kill some bad dudes. And I just got slugged pretty hard. So I'm playing these maps blind. Like, I literally just downloaded this in preparation for tonight's stream. And normally I give critique where I see necessary. Right off the bat, this is a beautiful map. 187 monsters. Yo, see, a lot of the gang is in here. Let me make sure I can read the chat and stuff. Hey, Scarecrow. Yeah, this is Biome by Pritchard. It came out probably last week, I think, or this week even. So, cool, I see the chat. AD's been a great experience. Map designs been far larger and more elaborate than ever experienced, of course. Yeah, AD truly is one of a kind. And all the stuff people make for AD. Probably should have started with a lighter map to begin with. It's pretty intense. Everything should be running fine, right? Let me know if it gets janky or laggy. Wow, a new game I have never seen before. Hello. Hello, hello. Yeah, see, that's why I wanted to stream this, because I know there's a lot of people who like shooting games who've never even seen all of the amazing maps that the Quake community makes. Not to mention the mods and stuff. Oh, key card required for lift. I will be safe scumming, so if that offends anybody. Yeah, first blood. But there's an invisible wall there. Don't really appreciate that too much. We'll pretend we didn't see it. as I understand, Pritchard made this originally for one of the Christmas jams. And the thing about that is, the Christmas jam rule is basically that everything has to be within a certain map size. So maybe that's why that is the way it is. Oh, wow. That's a close call. Love this little vegetation area. It's beautiful. Well, these guys are just spawning out of nowhere. No matter. There's plenty of ammo for them. The way that Pritchard uses his grenade, guys, is really good. Oh, yes, a real gun. Let me try and get caught up with you guys here. I know many people don't agree, but I usually play AD with FTEQW and HD textures. I don't agree. Yeah, cool. Been playing Quake lately. Loved your map in Dwell Episode 1. Yeah! Awesome. Dwell is quite a treat, man. I'm so happy to be part of that. That was such a fun map to make, and the one I'm working on, Top Secret, is shaping up to be quite the treat, too. Yeah, Dwell is where it's at. Ouch. So there's four secrets. I bet I missed them. I'm inclined to go back and explore a little bit. There's a silver key door here that has goodies beyond it. I don't want to swim in the lava. But maybe there's a secret there. Richard did an excellent job detailing all of this. I'm not very good at looking for secrets, so if it's painfully obvious and I miss it, just understand that it's in my nature. Let's proceed. Uh-oh. By the way, I'm sure someone will ask, I'm using Quake Spasm Spiked as my source port. And you should too. But of course, that's just my opinion. Uh-oh. This map has not let up, man. Very intense. I like the snow effect that Pritchard used here. Very cool. To bury some of the items slightly. It's a nice touch. Alas, we got a gold key. It makes really good use of these aerial monsters. Oh man, is this clipped? No, it's not. I just suck. Oh yeah, a secret. All right. Had to take advantage of that protection while I had it. Cool, so I found one of the four secrets in this map. Really dig this outdoor area. Really get a sense of place with those towers, or smokestacks rather, off in the distance. Okay, so we got the gold key. We know we gotta go back down. This place is just crawling with bad dudes. That was intense. Let me get caught up with you guys. Cheers, people. When I see 3D Realms doing old school stuff, I need to show it to all the kids. That's right. I'm new to modern Quake. What makes the source port stand out? I'm sure there will be people in the comments to... People in the chat can answer that, but... It's, for me, it's compatibility more than anything. And... It doesn't add anything, it just improves. I'm sure someone who uses FTE would say the same thing, but... Now is not the time to bicker about minor differences. Oh, look at that! I found the silver key. It was a secret. That was really well done. the way that Pritchard uses the negative space, like the air, and he fills it with flying monsters is just choice. Like, this is such a densely packed map, but it's also paced very decently. I think I gotta jump down here. I walked right into that. Ah, no underlift secrets here. Can't help but look, you know? Self-destruct. My kind of button. I'm gonna self-destruct. Yep. Oh! I guess you could say that's first blood for tonight. Yeah, Quake Spasm Spiked is the best for the old school classic look while retaining compatibility. FTE has the real-time lights and the modern look with all the bells and whistles. Yeah, that's why I don't like it that much. I prefer the classic look. It reminds me of when I played it as a child, you know? Okay, let me not die in this fight. All right, that's much better. Why, though? Yeah, good question. Oh, nice. Oh, I love that ending. How hilarious. It's Ranger who self-destructed. So, this was Biome by Pritchard. And actually, it has an AKA, which is Mr. Self-Destruct. Very appropriate, I guess you could say. So that's one off of my list of maps to play for tonight. I have to say, everything about this map was really well done. It's a nice layout. It's very compact and densely, like, there's a lot going on in this small area. I mean, I still missed two secrets. There's a lot of monsters, but Pritchard does a good job of trickling them in and setting up the fights just right so you don't feel overwhelmed or like you're grinding to get through the areas. So all in all, this was a very nicely put together map, and you could tell a lot of time and love went into making it. So awesome. And then the one I have next is, I don't remember what it's called. Long name. This one is by a unorthodox mapper named Quasiotter. And it is Calm Mood Rain Sounds. Calm Mood Rain Sounds? Forest Mushroom. Yeah. So, Quasiotter, he's best known for doing like very avant-garde, weird walking simulator type deals. And I figured it would be a good in between to check out between Biome and the map I have lined up after that. Let's check it out. There's books for us to read. Hello, you are greeted by an invisible force named Gerald. He serves you some spaghetti. It's delicious, and you thank him for the yummy. He tell go explore, and when done, quit. No exit, LOL. Okay. So, I guess it's just, get to walk around and see what's what. Pet frog. Whoa, that's a lot of text. Box. This looks pretty cool. I love the, raining sounds. It's very soothing. You approach Jim. You are scared. Because, you know, it's berry. I've not seen other berries like it. You fight your instinct and know it's berry. Because... Okay. There's even water for us to swim in. Yeah, all of Quasiotter's maps are very strange and not Quake-like at all. Yeah. This is neat. This might be my favorite map by Quasiotter, just because it's the most coherent. And I love the custom MS Paint textures. Check out that sky. You see pretty balloon. You tell the balloon they are pretty. Thank. What brings you here? You explain how you just needed to escape from your house a little bit. You need to socialize. And this was the first time it felt safe. No one has ever visited in over a year due to sick. We a couple people canceled. But you're actually the first to come. Let's see what the frog was talking. I think the frog might be my favorite, actually. Check out that face it's got. You pet frog. You're not long distance. You might ask the frog on a date. You really like the frog skin. Feels like wet velvet. Okay. You ask frog, how come teeth? Divergent evolution. Plus we got rid of bad guy. Not with knife, gun, drug. Kindness, love, heart. Yeah, all right. So there's a lot of deep lore going on here, that's for sure. I think Quasiotter could have put some secrets in here. Yeah, cool. Oh, is this a donut? Donut. This guy's name's Frederick. All right. Cool. So, next up, we have a map by Heresy. Imhotep's legacy. Heresy's working on Graven. I am too, but Heresy's killing it, man. And I take a lot of notes from his work. So he's got a pretty big map for us. 416 monsters, 12 secrets. This one should keep us busy for a while. I know Heresy's been working on this for more than a year, on and off, so it should be quite a treat. I remember he posted some screenshots of it around the time that we were preparing Dwell for release. Look at this place, dude. Right, we got a secret. This map begins like one from the Halloween pack. Yeah. Yeah. Hey, Skaki. Yeah, people still play games like this, I guess. It's kind of weird, right? It's nice to have games like this to play. Just can't help but look around at everything. And there's 12 secrets, so you know I'm going to be sticking my nose in every little corner. Oh, this track is from Dwell. Made by the very talented Alex with a K. Oh, wait till you guys hear his Dwell 2 stuff. Oh, man. So much fun stuff to come. Whoa, man. This is purple as hell. Man, these doorways, you know? I'm sure, like, the average person who's just who just wants action doesn't care, but, you know, the level designer in my heart is just looking at these doorways and is like, whoa. Them curves, man. Even these little light fixtures, torches, like, they're simple geometry, but they're, like, beautifully executed. Alright, let me not bore you guys with sweating the details. I knew I was going to be playing some hot maps, but man, this is hot. Hot stuff. I wonder if that's what I'm supposed to do. I should just grab that silver key. Oh. A bridge appears. Thank you. Dude, I feel like I can make that jump. Things got spicy for a second. I'm gonna come back when I have a bigger gun to deal with this guy. Oh, I have the bone key. Oh, wow. I feel a little undergunned right now. Maybe I should seek. Well, ammo maybe. This be dressed in yellow. Nice. Let me catch up with you guys a little. Is this the RTX fork? No, it isn't. Ah, Karaz says he's waiting for the headless kamikaze screen. Aren't we all? Maybe one day we'll see some headless kamikazes in Quake. That'd be pretty cool, huh? So again, the map is Imhotep's Legacy by Heresy for Arcane Dimensions. It came out maybe last week. Where did you get this mod? Yeah, I'll show you where you can get all that later. But basically, if you go to Quaddicted, that's the database where you can find all the latest Quake releases, as well as the Funk message board. I'll see if maybe Alex could like do a link or something to all this stuff. Yeah. Anyway, we must continue. Oh, that's cool. I love how he combined the like tech stuff with Egyptian. For Dwell, we did like gore stuff with Egyptian. Yes, another gun. Oh. Oh man, I got the secret but not the item. That was weak. Let me circle back. How am I going to leave without that? Whatever. I'll leave without it. I got the secret. So, that's almost as good. So just Mews are a little choppy. Map is very detailed and very intense. My toaster computer can barely handle it. Ouch. Cool pattern. And man, this texture work is just exquisite. What did that say? You must make a gift of flesh before getting out of here. What does that mean? Oh, that's funny. This is a neat little room to break up the pace. A little puzzle to stimulate the mind, you know? Cool. That was a cool little puzzle. Oh crap. Whoa. This one you think you've seen it all. Yeah, I'm playing it with Quake Spasm spiked. In fact, I think you need Quake Spasm spiked for this because it requires AD 1.8. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh. Was that gonna get him? Ah. Check out those Gibbs bouncing around everywhere. That's pretty good. What a neat effect. Okay, so I gotta rearrange these little crystals by randomly pressing these buttons. Oh, I had it for a second. This is the part where I show off my smooth brain. Very well designed puzzles here. Is that a secret? Here. There we go. R is always rocket launcher. Okay, now I can't stall any longer. I gotta solve this puzzle. I'm just pressing these buttons like a monkey. Funny, because I had it before, and I moved it. There we go. Was that? I love that he gave us the rocket launcher so soon. I mean, granted, it was a secret, but the fact that you can potentially get the rocket launcher this early on. That is awesome. It's happening. I feel like I didn't take advantage of that quad enough. I have a blue scarab key. Okay. I know there was something for that around here. Back towards the starting area. Beyond that shambler. No, this is where I came from. Oh, I need that. This ain't bad either, though. I still don't know how to get that without rocket jumping. I'm gonna use these boils to save some ammo. Let me get caught up with you guys a little bit. This map is wild, yes indeed. It looks mighty lovely. Yo, Alex with a K, what's up, man? R for me is SSG? What are you doing? You crazy. R is always rocket launcher. R? You can't spell rocket launcher without R. All right, I'm gonna check what's beyond these little obelisks here. Oh, not quite. Probably have to do it in one smooth, like, series of jumps. I don't think I have that in me. Yeah, I don't have it in me. Oh. Okay, so let's get back on task. I have a blue scarab key. I need to find where to use it. It was probably right in front of me, and I just didn't see it. Okay, so the yellow one's used here. Can we be back this way? There's another shooty button around here. That's probably how I get the super shotgun. Ah. The Widowmaker is available. Oh, yes. Do you feel powerful? Nothing like a little triple barrel shotgun action. Now I just need to find bad dudes to use it on. So I'm going to backtrack a little bit in an effort to find that blue scarab door. I know that was to disable the trap. What map pack is this? This is actually a standalone map for Arcane Dimensions called Imhotep's Legacy by mapper Heresy, who is also working on Graven at the moment. He's working on Graven, and this is what he does in his spare time. He makes maps like this. So, like, he wasn't even trying, you know? He just made this. Probably blindfolded, even. Blindfolded while bored on a Saturday morning while having his coffee. Probably just like that. Of course, I'm like super lost. Oh. I guess I was supposed to come back this way. I feel like the shotgun is lagging every time I shoot it. I wonder what that's about. Oh, there's the door. This is now the lag cannon. Is it added to the AD update? No, this is a standalone map you download on your own. Quake is timeless when people still make amazing maps for it. Some particle effects are... Yeah, hey, Mazu. Yeah, let me know how to disable those, because... pretty bad right now. I don't know if that's just Quake Spasm spiked, or what. It's funny because the explosions aren't even that bad. PR checks check extensions. Let's try that. Check extensions. Zero. Let me just back up my save here. Let's see how that goes. Oh yeah! Thank you, Mazu. That definitely did the trick. It also changed my HUD to the classic one. But that's fine, because I like the classic one, actually. I'm gonna just adjust the scale a tad here. Cool, okay. Now we can continue lag-free. Yeah, AD 1.8 does a lot of stuff to the game itself. They're right behind me, aren't they? Oh yeah. Mazu, you saved the day. Gotten the Widowmaker anyways. That. Hang on, he's gonna have to wait. I gotta figure out how to get that red armor. The thing about good secret design, you should never be too far from the answer. Alright, this guy isn't gonna let up, so... Thank you. I remember I have this rocket launcher. Okay, well, now I definitely need that red armor, so... I should put that thing away. Alright, cool. Where was I? Oh, almost. I feel like that was easier than it should have been for a red armor. Not that I'm complaining. Okay, so I have the gold scarab key. I think the gold scarab key is used over here. No, not here. I would say that's one of the biggest challenges when you're making a map this vast. Oh! Jump boots. For me, the jump boots are a very special item because I helped create them thanks to the boots. Ah, so that's how you get it. Yeah, the jump boots in Arcane Dimensions are based on my jump mod, which is a standalone Quake mod. I released that, what, January of last year? And it was very well received by the community, thankfully. At least from the feedback I've seen. Dude, I'm getting wrecked. One way to do it. Oh man, I bet I can make this jump now. Cool. And I know the scarab door is right over there. We're getting close to the end here. Keys look very good, but you take them too fast. Whoa. Oops. This should be doable with the jump boots. Oh, how about that? Boom. Did I just break the map sequence? We'll find out. Ow. Rude, man. Oh, this is crazy. Looks like I have some buddies to help me. Oh man, he's just throwing everything at us. I'm getting out of here. Ooh, I'm hurt. You know what that means? Quick save. I love how he put all these extra health packs in the just slightly out of reach places. No, I don't play WoW. JCR are my initials. Alright. This is like the finale, man. Wow. Alright, no dying edition. Take one of these and I'll save that for later. What? I missed that guy. Crazy. Oh man, there's too many of them. I gotta get out of here. Oh, you know what? I remember now. I made the sound effects for the jump boots for this. I remember it sounded familiar for a reason. That's a cool-ass skybox. Looks like some Doom Eternal type shit. How about that, huh? Imhotep's legacy map you can find for Arcane Dimensions. Yeah. On Funk message board, as well as Quedicted. This is an awesome map. I mean, there's so much to it, and the quality of the art and everything that went into this, the layout, you know, Heresy's brushwork, just a masterpiece. A masterpiece for sure. So, that was quite something. What do I have next? Circulation of Shadows. This is not Arcane Dimensions. This is old school Quake. And Circulation of Shadows is a map pack, or rather a map that was made by Bao, but never finished until Greenwood picked it up and completed it. I didn't really look at the readme, so I could be wrong there, but I think that's what the deal is here. Is this a skill select? Affer. Circulation of Shadow. It's funny not to be playing Arcane Dimensions for a change. Some proper old school Quake. Oh, I guess Greenwood included some of the custom monsters. Shout out to Elias and Della. Have I played Scourge of Armagon? Yeah. Alright, gotta stop that. That didn't work at all. Ouch. I had to check. Can't help it. Cool, so there are some custom enemies in here. Oh, what's that guy? Oh, that's hilarious. It's like a death knight, but for the base. And he's got like an energy sword or something. That's pretty damn cool. I've never seen that before. I'm telling you guys. There's always something new to be seen here. The Quake scene. He says not to kill the Floyd. Sorry. That's hilarious. They even have like a lightsaber sound effect. Oh man, I love it. Damn, those guys should be in Arcane Dimensions. I also like the custom track for this map. Very fitting. Not sure what that button did. Quake is the game that started the modding scene proper. I'm sure many would argue that it's Doom. I'm not gonna pretend like I know. Because Doom has so many awesome mods too. And the Doom community, man, that is just such an amazing, amazing community. Constantly pumping out new stuff. Oh, this button goes into the literally unplayable. Oh, this is awesome. That's the area we were just at, all the way down there. I wonder. Oh, yeah. Sweet. One of the five secrets has been found. Huh. Those hoverboard guys with the nail guns. I love them. I use them a great deal in my jump mod maps. Check that out. Damn, almost got me with that backspawn. Oh man, this is pretty funny. It's like some kind of turret. Really clever. Oh, even the fiends got a tech facelift. Pretty dope. Hey Skaki, are those laser sword guys from Rubicon 2 though? Or are they just like a new addition? But yeah, like the Floyd and the hoverboard guys are definitely Rubicon. But I don't recall seeing those laser sword guys anywhere. Yeah, those must be new for this then. I have a feeling I'm gonna die here. Uh-oh. Oh, that's close. Okay. There's my path. That's pretty neat. I love jumping puzzles. Usually they're not very complicated and they're quite fun. One second. Where can you get this? You can get this on Quaddicted. You could also look on Funk Message Board. As far as, like, setting it up, I did a quick start video that might be useful. Maybe someone could link it. Otherwise, I'll link it at the end of my stream here. I'll see if, Alex can, like, link it or something. It reminds me of the conveyor belt area in Half-Life, except not unpleasant. I kind of like the funk train sounds here. It doesn't have to be high tech. I was on fire too much to appreciate that door opening. So this map, for those who missed out, is by Bao, but it was never completed. So Greenwood completed it and released it as a collaboration. Man, this is really impressive. It just keeps going. Okay, so I have to come back. I love this exit gate. That shit is really cool. This whole map. Like, once you come topside, it really establishes a sense of place. Like, you just emerge from this facility, you know? Oh, I thought I got the gold key. Oh, crap. Oh boy, that was pretty bad. Now I got the gold key. Yeah, that skybox is dope. For sure. Looks like we're in for a action-packed ending.
Hmm.
I am dead years old. Okay, don't fall in there. Oh! Bite the curveball. Oh, cool. Look at that. Nice effect on the exit and everything. Yeah, that little pit drop was a little raw, but not too shabby. Not too shabby. That exit was cool, where it was like a little hover bike vehicle thing. And yeah, the ceiling was too low, but nobody saw that. What a cool map. I really enjoyed this. So, those are the four maps that I had lined up. And we're getting pretty close to the end here. Why don't I share with you guys my quick start video. Let's see if I can do this without causing too much trouble. Okay, check this out. So that's a link to my quick start video for Quake. You can it basically gives you a no nonsense, like super quick way to get your Steam version of Quake set up to play all this cool stuff. It also shows you where you could find all these maps. And what the hell? Let's play a couple more, right? We have Start BSP at home. This is the Quake Snack Pack. My Cheeto fingers are ruining the scan. Feel Cheeto dust. Okay. So this is a speed map pack that came out pretty much at the beginning of the year. Let's see if I can blow this up from here. Okay. So it just does a kill target or something. The Schamburger. There are four more to go. So I guess you can find all the snacks. That's how you exit to the nightmare difficulty. But we're playing on hard, so I'm not gonna... This music is driving me a little crazy, too. Yo, Quasiotter, I played your mushroom map. That was a nice little break. Dog barking over voice chat. This is a speed map by Bao, actually. The thing I like about speed maps is they're usually very small and bite-sized. You can play a ton of them. And you get a lot of variety from different authors. Classic. Oh, yeah. Wow, this is 15 maps. I'm probably not gonna play all this. The burnout's gonna happen eventually, and I'm gonna embarrass myself in front of everybody. But for now, let us push forward. So I need a silver key. I love when maps combine like indoor and outdoor spaces. Really does wonders for the setting. Also, it's a great place to hide stuff. I didn't even realize the key was up here. Very well done. Oh man, that hurt. You know I got a quick save. Oh man, I put myself in a really bad position. Probably shouldn't have gotten wailed on so hard. Let's try again. And I gotta concentrate for this. This map is awesome. It's legit really damn good. Yeah, I might restart it if I can't beat it this time, because I screwed it up. Time to do some Twitch streamer clutch mode. Yeah, I think I could do it. Ah! I think it can be done. Just one more. Alright, nah, restart. Sorry.
foot.
Really did myself in with that one. Now we can make it a cool speedrun, though. Feel like I'm doing much better this way. Alright, a little bit more health than last time. Okay. Should be good to do this now. Oh yeah, 1 HP. That was clever. You basically have like a time-limited shambler threat. You see what I mean? I love this about speed maps. Like, here's an area that is just roughly blocked out. And it's just there for you to... You get the idea, you know? Brilliant. Brilliant map. So, not too shabby. A place we all know, like Chris Holden. Chris is also working on Graven. This map's oddly familiar. Which source port? So this is the Quake Spasm Spike. Which is what you should be using too. in my humble opinion. That water's right at the brim. Look at that. Just watching a quick start vid, first suggestion would be to use theme local files button to get the files. Yeah, there's a million ways to slice it. But I know that way works. I had to guess, there's one of these shooty buttons in every area of the map, so I'm gonna try and keep my eyes peeled for it. Was there one here? Ah, yes. That's the exit, but we don't want to hit this just yet. We want to find that last shoot button. The nice thing about this pack is that the maps are sequential, so items carry over. And that really encourages some exploration. Hey, Rock. Okay, cool, I found it. Yep. Chris, the super secret area. It's the only secret I found in the whole map, but it's the super secret one. Hey, I'm hosting 3D Realms because I'm streaming on 3D Realms. That was a neat little map. Next up is one by MC. Who is MC? Slip it inside. Tell you what, it's a lot of tech bases in this pack. Yeah, I mean, I barely understand how it works either. But yeah, I'm streaming on 3D Realms account. There's so much Quake stuff coming out though. Like, this is what I played tonight is just like a super tiny slice of all the maps that are coming out. There's a ton of new mappers, tons of new content. Oh crap. Like, you could play Quake for a very long time and not see the same thing from the same mapper even. I mean, at the end of the day, you're shooting monsters, right? Like, it's Quake, but you're gonna get a huge variety of maps from different people. And in a great volume that hasn't really slowed down. It base is such a wholesome texture set. Yes, it is. Which pack is this? This is the snack pack. Skaki says he's a couple years behind Quake releases. Yeah. Hey, Shamblernaut's here. We got the whole gang. The whole Quake gang. Yeah, any of these guys can vouch for just the sheer number of new releases. I'm getting out of here. Oh. So close, yet so far. Oh yeah, Rock. If you start streaming the new releases, you'll never finish. They just keep coming. Oh crap, I'm gonna get out of here. Ah, so close! Alright. I'm gonna try and play this cool and collected. Alright, that. Wow, this is a tough exit, man! Okay. We're not dying this time. Ooh boy! Slick. Oh yeah, Tears was a great map. Laser Party Vigilante. Hey, were tech bases like the theme here, or is it just that everybody made tech bases? Not that I mind, I really like tech base, to be honest. The biggest drawback is the lack of monster variety on maps like this. Which I don't agree with. I think you could, even if it's a base, like, just mix it up with monsters. But I'm having a great time. So I hope it's entertaining for you guys. This almost looks like a climate. So this is Laser Party Vigilante by Mr. Hater. He might be in here right now. Oh, that was close. Oh. Dude, this map is awesome. Really digging it. We made that quad count. That was good. Hey, that was awesome. You know, I don't like the dogs as an enemy, but man. This is excellent use of them, especially for like a backspawn ambush. How am I not dead? Oh yeah. That's what that is. Talk about subverting expectations. I thought I was out. Nice. How long did they get? That's a good question. There's probably some authors from the snack pack in here right now, so maybe someone can answer that question. How long did these maps take? I want to say it was probably 24 hours, but maybe longer? Oh, I gotta do a tactical reload here on my water mug. Nine hours? Cool. Based by Burnham. Biohazard activated. What does that mean? Oh. Sweet. Huh. Neat. I like that quad run. That was pretty cool. Varied. Some spent few hours up to 24. Not bad. Not bad for 9 to 24 hours. Spasmodic peristalsis. Greenwood. Greenwood is a very talented mapper, and all of his work is always something new. Like, he's always up to something. And in my opinion, like, he uses just the right amount of details. Like, he's really good at the classic Quake look, but cleaned up. Oh. Oh, yeah. Alright, I'm happy with that quad run. That was a good quad. Push me off. Clever guy. I love the underwater combat here. That is an intense battle. Tell you what, I'm not a fan of like the regenerating supplies, but this is a good use of those mechanics. especially for like long fights like that. That actually worked out quite well. Boy, that hurt. This is why I don't like the regenerating, because it kind of kills the pace. But I think what kills the pace more is those just two shamblers at the exit. Oh! That damn thing. Oh. 3 HP. The show must go on, though. I wouldn't call it a speed run, but these are speed maps. 3 HP is plenty, right? Especially because you start off with 50 on the next. Decay in Green by Henry. Oh yeah, Henry is quite the mapper too. He did one of the maps in Dwell. Oh man, all is good. Found the mega health, so we're golden. I like that we're moving away from the tech bases now into green brick. When I think of Quake, this is the kind of setting that I imagine. Every shot. There we go. Within a secret, how about that? Man, Henry killed it with this one. Quality of this map for being 24 hours, it's just unbelievable, man. Unbelievable. For me, this is what like the perfect Quake map is about. You got a small number of enemies, a couple secrets, really nice layout, you know, and a cool setting and atmosphere. What more could you want from a speed map? It's brilliant stuff, Henry. What's this? Cloister of the Damned. By Artistical. Oh, this is awesome. Artistical lately has been, in my opinion, a controversial mapper. But I've always believed in him. I knew he could make good maps. Though some of his maps are far from my favorites. A nice combination. Well, I mean, I guess it's 8-1, but then he has this nave, the nave bookshelf textures and the glass. Looks good. Reminds me of that one map from Destroyer. Looks like he's glitched. Oh, cool. I'll take it. Nice. I knew Artistical could make a good map. This is a good map. I'm very pleased by it. The Dumb Place by Creator. Greenwood, is that you? Creator is one of the brains behind Dwell. And he's doing a lot of heavy lifting for Dwell Episode 2. Oh, this is pretty cool. Huh. Hey! Is that you, Fairweather? Come on, what are you expecting to do? I'm sorry to see you didn't make it. Still, it looks great. Feel free to message me if you were planning something specific for the map. I'll finish it. Also, did Artistical help make, help finish this? Is that what this is about? Is this the Artistical area? That's really funny. Oh, I get it. It's a hallway. That was true art, Artistical. Thank you. Oh wow, look at this bridge, how cool. Oh. Dynamite. Oh, I missed a ton of stuff. What's that about? As a casual viewer, it's so refreshing to watch someone playing this game so flawlessly. I'm just having a good night, that's all. Chonkwell by Pinchy. Yeah, the way I'm gonna complete this whole pack. And I'll have my fill of Quake by then. That's a big ass map, dude. A good night, but also you got skills. Oh, this one. I ran this one in a weird order and died a lot. Oh, you mean you didn't play them in order? Am I not supposed to do that? Oh, hey, Pinchy. Oh. Pinchy says this is a hot mess. Whoa. That's crazy. So those spikes just insta-gibbed everything in here. Shamblers telefrag themselves, nice. Saves a bunch of ammo indeed. Ammo that is becoming a premium. Here goes. Thank you. Man, Pinchy done put me underwater with a boar. It's getting spicy. Oh man, there's just too many tough dudes. Low on health and ammo, but we gotta make it happen. He says he ran out of ammo. Had to axe a few times. Oh, thankfully, the axe and copper is pretty good. Shit. Oh, boy. Maybe I should look for that secret. Oh, it's back there, that quad. Could have used that. Too late now. That was pretty intense. No time for mercy. Wow, a speed map by Void Force. And it's completely... Why did I do that, man? That didn't count. That was just practice. Moved into metal. One of Quake's strongest themes, in my opinion. Oh, what? Oh, shit! That's not the secret I was looking for. Oh, that was brutal, man. Brutal. Oh, this is a brutal ass room. This map is serious business. Okay, let's do it without dying this time. I'm really enjoying this pack. Dude, that is intense. Yes. I'd say this might be the most difficult map in the pack so far. Oh boy. Oh, what? Oh, this is insane! I gotta get out of here. I love it. I love it, but I don't got time for that. Well, that was creative. Humming Tunnels by Nemeth. Nemeth is another recent mapper who has made a lot of really cool stuff. Nemeth's maps are very atmospheric and got a cool, like, mood going. Map's pretty dope too. Not quite what I wanted to happen, but okay. That was a little brutal. It totally might do it too. No more dying. What's interesting is, this one seems to be open-ended. Like, I can approach it a couple different ways. Make it over those. Lift locked by four buttons. The rocket launcher is Quake's sniper weapon. All right. I remembered to quick save. This map is very engrossing. Fortunately, I think I gotta swim now. Thank you. 4 more to go. I feel like this is kind of a chore. Because it's kind of hard to see under here. No matter. We will find the buttons. One more. Of course, that's when it's most difficult. Yeah, okay, I already hit one. It's probably back here. Oh, lightning gun available. The secret. All right. I love the underwater lightning gun. Bethesda. For the time being. Not a bad reward for doing your chores. Where is that last mechanism then? Okay, so it's not this way. There's the last mechanism. All right. The exit is now open for us. All right. Let me not die in this room now. Sweet. Yeah, this was a really cool map. I felt like it was a little long-winded, but that's all right. I think there was a lot of substance to this map. Made it very playable. Un nom français esoterique by French Weather. An esoteric French name. Of course. So this is what? Map? What map is this? Map 13. I think there's two more after. Huh. Oh. Oh, that is pretty cool. This map be off the goof. Wait, what do I do now? I still got too much quad. Not the best use of a quad, but whatever. That'll work. Oh yes, of course. That is, for real, like, where Quake's monsters really shine. Quake's monsters are most effective in, like, these tight little areas. Ouch. Alright, you know what? I'm out of here. Oh, that was close. It's been long since I played Quake. Like, decades. Dude, there's a lot of really cool new Quake stuff. Like this. The Legacy of Ebonero's Lost Kingdom. By Mazu. Oh boy. We're in for a long one here. Mazu is very well known for making super big Quake maps that command a lot of attention and a lot of skill. It's a cool secret. Am I dead? I'm dead. Dead as hell. Tell you what, guys. I'll be right back. And I'll pick this up in a second. Okay, here we go. We've been looking at Dusk and Wrath. Yeah, they're good. Wrath is definitely awesome. A lot of the guys in the chat right now are working on Wrath. Or some of them are. Okay, let's try this map again without dying. Without dying. Good luck? Psh, man. I'm a Quake pro. We're gonna do this without dying. If I can help it. Oh. Don't panic. Alright. It's time for real, for real. We're not drowning. We're not dying this time. That is hilarious. I like this underwater puzzle. It's really cool. Or it's like a little maze. Alright, cool. We did. So I get the feeling we're in for a lot of traps and stuff like that. There was a secret in here. Let me find it. How did I get to that? Ah, here it is. Here goes. Man, I was feeling pretty good about dodging all that, and then get wailed from behind with a friggin' grenade. Ah, I got him. Just use the power of believing in yourself. That's basically what's gotten me this far. Found a secret that shouldn't be a secret. I'll take it. Uh, this door? Button off. Sweet. Ah, ooh, that was close. The rockets when you need them. There you are. Gorgeous map. Not bad for 24 hours. Oh man. That guy took a bite out of me. Yeah, I got no ammo. Let me just go back here. See if I missed something. There's three other secrets. Something opened underwater. Oh, crap. 8 hours? You made this in 8 hours? Oh, man. Okay, right. So this is the part where I retreat. Because I ain't fighting those guys with only shells. And I'm going to go over here. Climb up this thing. Something opens underwater. I like that secret area, though, with the spawns. That is really funny. All right, much better. And actually, a good chunk of HP too. Found rockets, not that that will help me against those shamblers. What the? Let me see if I go around him. No. Guess there's no escape. They have me choked out. Rockets aren't horrible. They're just cost ineffective. Yeah, well, I mean, when you're down to 7 rockets, it's not a good economic decision. But so is neither is tanking them with your HP. I'm out of here. Oh no, I almost got out of there. Damn it. I do. I'm gonna have to try the same thing. Okay, cool. That's all the enemies. Let's move on to the finale. It's a cool map. Very cool map. There's a secret that I missed. One of the three. The Fever Palace by Newhouse. Oh. Definitely looks like a Newhouse map. Yeah, we don't get that many. We don't get that many Newhouse maps these days. Should have known that would happen. Spawns are a great enemy. They're like exercise and trigger control. Hey, Newhouse, how long did this take you to make? Yeah, it's the Quake Snack Pack. This was released... what, in early January. I was gonna get smacked by those nails. A pit! Yeah, I'm trying to unwind a little bit here, and I would say it's been largely good. I haven't really played games in a while now. Just been making levels and stuff. That didn't work as planned. In my opinion, New House is like the Finnish Sandy Peterson. How am I gonna survive that room? I don't know. Okay, so I need 3 keys to exit this area. You see that? I'm starting to tilt already. So good thing this is the last map. There is a way to survive, I'm sure. I just don't see it right now. But I got an idea. Totally stole that mega health. Get away! Couldn't get away. and I didn't quick save after that fight, but it's alright. I don't know what Newhouse wants me to do to get that, but I'm doing that. To adequately prepare me for this battle. Be a good place to hide a secret of some kind. Red windows are the key. Let me get caught up with you guys. I see I've received a hint. The slime pool hides a secret. But am I a bad enough dude to get it? Man, I don't see no secret. I think I got trolled. Anyway, red windows. Oh, no! Curious. Alas, we done did it. What an awesome pack. This was an awesome pack. Speed maps are really my favorite because since you don't have a lot of time, you can't get caught up in the concerns of like detailing the maps and anything like that. It's pure concept, you know? And like Newhouse is a great example of pure concept. This is a great pack. Really enjoyed it. And I've been streaming for a lot longer than I intended to. So thank you guys for joining me on my 3D Realms debut. It's weird. Streaming on the 3D Realms channel. Hopefully I'll do it again. It will depend on timing and schedule and all that stuff. But for those of you who may not know, I make Quake maps. I play Quake maps. And I'm helping with Graven. I'm helping with Twitch streaming for Three Realms too, I guess. But yeah, I'm pretty spread thin these days, so. Yeah, I'm also helping with Redacted. But more on that later. Yeah, I got nothing else to say, but thank you guys for joining me. I hope this was an entertaining evening. I really enjoyed it. This was pretty fun. I haven't played Quake in a minute, so cheers.